Hello. Hi, everyone. Good evening. Can someone please confirm if you can see my screen and am I audible? Yeah, thanks, everyone. Okay, we'll wait for just 1 or 2 minutes for the participants to join, and then we'll start. So Suga is asking whether this will be posted on YouTube. Yes, this video will be posted on YouTube. So you can follow it from there as well. Okay, so we'll begin. I'm Vikram Bajaj. I work as CEO at Raytheon. And this is our weekly webinar on strategy creation. So welcome you all for this webinar. And this is the strategy that we are trying to build today. This is set up based on RSI and ADX and has multiple option positions, which will be bought based on RSI range. So we'll just quickly have a look at the strategy conditions and then we'll start building it. So the basic setup is if RSI is between 45 and 55, then we'll short a straddle or strangle. So in this case, we'll short a straddle. If this range is broken, then it is exiting and opening a bullish or bearish triangle based on the side of RSI. If RSI is going lower, then it will be a bearish triangle. And if it is going higher, it will be a bullish triangle. And after that range, it is just making a naked call or naked put open position on the short side. So this is the setup. Let's start building the first condition in this. So this is Raytheon's create strategy page. Here you can define name of your strategy. Okay, so we have named our strategy. Here you can write the description about the strategy. Now we'll start with the place where you have to write the conditions and you can add positions for your strategy. This is set number one. Like this, you can have more than one set as well in your strategy. We'll create the strategy on Nifty. So first I'll add the positions. Self call of Nifty. ATM. For now, I'll keep it as NRML only. And we'll trade on monthly options. So I've added a call, and similarly, I'll add one more position to sell put. Will be again Nifty, ATM, and three dots. Okay, now we'll start the condition. We want to enter this position when RSI ranges between 45 and 55. So for this, we go to add condition. Here, there's a list of all the keywords that we have. So to add any technical indicator, you have to start with position keyword. So position minus one will allow you to select the previous bar to the current bar. So zero stands for the latest bar for today's candle, or if you're working with lower time frame, let's say 1 hour. So current hour candle, and if you want to select previous candle, it will be minus one. So here we'll select RSI. Then we'll define the instrument name, which is Nifty. And as you want to do analysis on futures, we'll select current month as expiry. Now to change the time frame, currently it is by default, it is set to daily candle. So we'll change it to 15 minutes for this strategy. And RSI period also you can change from here. Let's say if you want to take 10 period RSI or 14, you can select it from here. So I'll keep it 15 only. So our basic condition is RSI should be greater than 45. And so you can also copy and paste blocks from here. So you just have to click on this button and paste it. This should be less than 55. Okay. So when this condition is true, it will enter the short straddle position. Now let's write condition to exit these both positions. So I'll just copy the same block, paste it here. And we will change this AND to OR. So any of the condition meets, we want to exit, which is if RSI is less than 45, then we want to exit from this straddle, or if RSI value goes above 55. So this will exit the position that you have taken in this straddle. Now we'll add one more set for. Now we'll move towards this call position side. So we'll add one more set, and in this we will add this bearish strangle position. So to make a bearish strangle, we have to select near month call or near the ATM strike basically, and out of the money strike for put. So for call, we'll be selecting a strike which is closer to the money. So we'll select FX here. And if you want to select one step out of the money call, so you can select ATM keyword here. Nifty will be your underlying. And one will be the step. So if you want to go 50 points out of the money, you will select one. If you want to go 100 points out of the money, you can select two here. Lots will again keep same three. And for put, we will select OTM put, which is two strikes away from current ATM. So to select two steps out of the money put, we have to put step as minus two here. Okay. Yeah. And our entry condition here will be, you can again copy entry from set one, paste it here. And here our condition will be, it should be less than 45. And greater than 40. So we have defined entry condition and the initiation positions for this particular set. Now, as soon as RSI goes above 45, we want to change. As you can see on the screen, we want to change this position to triangle, from bearish triangle to regular triangle. So how to do that? Let's check here. So we'll add a repair condition here. So repair once will be triggered when a condition is true. So this condition again will be, we'll copy this, paste it here. And if this value goes above 45, we don't need this rule. So one rule only we have for this condition. And here your positions will be. So now here basically I have to square up this call which I have selected in entry condition, and sell another call which is one strike above the same call. So how to select a particular strike which you have already traded in particular set? So it will be a buy position of call. Underline will be again Nifty. So in strike we'll use a formula. So we'll select FX for that. And there is a keyword for this named traded instrument. So for this set, it was an entry type of condition. I want to select strike of that particular leg which was traded. Underlined is Nifty. This is set number 2. There is only one entry condition, so condition number 1. And it is leg number 1. If I want to fetch the strike of put, then I would have selected leg number 2 here. Quantity will be again 3 lots. I have added that position. And now I want to sell a call which is 50 points away from the same strike. So I'll add 50 to this. So this is leg 1 and this will be leg 2. So what we are doing here is we are buying this particular call and we are selling a call which is 50 points away from the same strike. So we are converting that position to a triangle. And exit condition for this rule will be if RSI goes above 55. So as soon as the value goes above 55, then again we'll exit from this set. So in this set, we have seen how to create a position. And in the middle of a set, if you want to change or based on any condition, if you want to change a particular position in your portfolio, how you can do that using repair once condition, how you can fetch the strike of a particular instrument which was traded in previous condition, or you can also select a strike across set if you want to build a strategy like that. So now we have seen this this orange colored condition and one above it. Similar, the condition above it, 35 to 40 range of RSI, will be again similar to what we have created in set 2. Now we'll jump to this 30 to 35 percent condition and we'll club this two conditions basically in one set. So we'll create set 3 for that. So for our set 3, the range will be 40 to 35. So again, I'll copy this entry condition, paste it here. It's greater than 35 and less than 40. Position will be simple. It's only one leg. We have to sell a call. We'll sell ATM call, let's say 3 lots. Exit condition of this rule will again be same, similar to what we have put in entry condition. So if RSI value goes above 40, we will exit from here. Now let's look at how we will handle this thing. To add more calls or add more calls and exit from the position, partially exit from the position when closing goes above EMA 30. So let's add two repair conditions to do that. In the same set, I'll add one repair once. So we want to make this adjustment when RSI value goes between 35 and 30, let's say. So we'll again start with positions, RSI. Instruments will select NFO Nifty 50. Current month. Candle type is 15 minutes. Yeah. So this value is less than 35. And same value should be greater than 30. So we get a range of RSI. It should be between 30 and 35 for this condition to be satisfied. And we have one more additional condition here, which is based on ADX, whether ADX is rising or falling. So to check that, we have to compare previous two values of ADX. So let's see how to do that. We have to add again, start with position, ADX. Symbol will be again, NFO Nifty. Per month. This will be 15 minutes. So ADX should be falling. So I'll just copy and paste this block. And here I change the position to -2. So this will basically compare previous candle ADX with its previous value. Once this is true, then we'll add a position to sell one more option, one more call option of the same strike. So we'll select NFO, this will be sell call. Strike again will be a formula, and we'll select the strike, which was, so we'll find out what was the ATM when entry was taken. And we'll use traded instrument keyword again for that. This is set 3 and it has only one leg. So condition 1 and leg 1. So it will sell more 3 lots here. So now we have added this condition. So if RSI is between 30 and 35 and ADX is falling, then we have to sell more calls. Now we'll write the exit condition. We'll write this exit condition, partial exit. We need to exit 1/3 of the quantity when price closes above EMA 13. So for that, we will write one more repair once. And condition will be closing. Previous candle close. Is greater than SMA. EMA, let's check. Okay, it's EMA. So we'll change it to EMA. will be a 15 minute candle again, and period will be 13. Okay, so if closing is above 13 period EMA, then we want to exit 1/3 of the quantity. So now in quantity formula, we will write a formula to select 30% of the net quantity open in this particular call. So it will be a buy position on call Nifty. Strike again, we'll select from the same formula. Period instrument. Entry price of Nifty. And quantity formula will be net quantity of our traded instrument divided by number 3. So 1/3 quantity, it will automatically calculate, and based on if repair once has happened or no, based on that, it will find what is 1/3 of the total open quantity and trade that. So this will be instrument. And add a position. So like this, we have created total 3 sets in our strategy, one for the base condition, one for this condition, one for this range, and one for handling two different RSI price range. So how to take entry and how to do partial exit, and how to add more sets, how to add more number of positions if price goes or RSI value goes in lower direction, and a combination of RSI with ADX. So we have written condition based on that as well. So we have covered like almost all the combinations which are given in this sheet. Now we'll take some questions. I'll just create this strategy. So once you have filled in all the conditions and positions, and also yeah, universal exit we'll discuss. So as I have kept every position as NRML, so I wish to exit this portfolio on day of expiry, let's say. So how you can write that condition? Today is equal to, if today is current month expiry, and time is greater than 3:15. So I want to exit. If you want to trade this strategy intraday only, then you just have to write this time condition. You don't have to put this expiry condition. So it will exit all the position at 3:15 on day of expiry. And I'll just create that. So this we have done only for the call side. I have already created all the sets on the put side as well. So I'll just share the link of that strategy with you. You can duplicate it in your account and play around with the conditions. So this is the link of the strategy. I'm sharing it with you all on chat. Okay, so I'll start taking the questions now. So Naveen is asking, what is -1 in the position that I have given? So basically on any chart, position 0 will be the latest candle. -1 will stand for previous candle, -2 for previous to previous candle. So whichever value I want to compare with the current, I mean, whatever reference I want to give from the current candle, I can give it using the position keyword. Okay, Suga is asking what happens if RSI goes above 50. So you can put the exit conditions accordingly, at what level you want to exit all the open positions from a particular set. So whenever that level is hit, it will exit from the position. Manoj is asking how to add stop loss in futures positions. So position, again, as in this strategy, we have used, let me go to the strategy again. So here, as we have used SMA as one of the criteria to exit partial position. So similarly, you can have stop loss based on some technical indicator, or you can also write any condition based on the price. So you can just take LTP of any particular traded instrument. When LTP goes below traded value, I mean traded, again, the price, entry price, and multiply it with some number, which is your stop loss or target profit. And it will give you a number. Basically, you can exit at 50 rupee profit or 1% profit or 1% stop loss, like that. Vivek is asking what type of orders we have. So currently we have MIS and NRML orders only. So cover order and bracket order are not there as of now. If we can create a strategy on our own, do we have to share code with Tradetron? So no, basically we don't keep your strategy stored at one place. It is distributed in multiple subsets. So nobody actually have access to your strategy, and it is password protected by your account. So yeah, this was Naveen's question. Kalpesh is asking if this is backtested. No, this strategy is not backtested. It was shared on a social media platform from where we picked it, and we are trying to recreate that strategy here on Tradetron. Suman is asking, how do I check if any position exists in either call or put? So this is really interesting, and we'll see how you can do that. So position details is a keyword basically which allows you to do that. So across your strategy, you can aggregate or sum up quantity or traded value, which is price into quantity, based on type of condition. So if I select all, it will be across all the positions, across all sets in that strategy. If I select entry, then it will be selecting all entry positions or the positions which were taken through entry condition. Then you have another filter based on buy and sell value. So if you select buy, so all the entries which had buy positions, so that will be summed. If you select all, then all, otherwise call or based on call or put type also you can select it. So if I select call, so now this will sum up all the entry positions which had buy positions and were of option type as call. Then you can select quantity here and underlying also. So if you have a strategy based on Nifty, Bank Nifty both, so you can select I want only call positions in Nifty. So you select Nifty as underlying here and it will give you that. And you can compare this. If this value is equal to zero, then there is no position for this call. This can be your condition to take an action. Shitaj is asking which broker we are connected with. So you can check partners page on our website. So we are connected with 10 brokers in India as of now. Rajan is asking, will NRML positions will be held till expiry? Yes, it will be. What happens if open position, open quantity is 2 and not completely divisible by 3? So it will round up to the highest value. So 2 divided by 3 will be 0.66. So it will trade one lot. Is there any feature to see the trade confirmation? So yeah, once a condition is confirmed and trade is taken, it will be shown on deployed page. So you can just deploy a strategy once you create on paper trading to check whether it is taking proper positions or no. And then if you're comfortable with that, then you can go for live trading. How one can edit the RSI option strategy? So the strategy link that I have shared, you can duplicate the strategy. Once you click on duplicate, a copy of the strategy will be created in your account. You can edit it, change the parameters, add more conditions, more sets. Kiran is asking if we have any templates. Yes. So here we have added a list of some strategies and with their conditions and positions pre-filled. So you can use these strategies, you can easily duplicate these and create your own strategies around it. So I'm sharing the link with you. You can copy it from there. Is it possible to use trailing stop loss individually with all positions traded in a strategy? As of now, Manoj, we don't have such functionality to add trailing stop loss individually on instrument, but we are looking how we can put it in the strategy builder. Shetaj, yes, you can create iron condor strategy and execute all legs at once. All you have to do is just put entry condition. It can be blank also. And in positions, you can just add all the four legs of your iron condor and deploy it. It will take all the four trades in one go. Okay, Ankit wants me to show how to select ATM plus 100 call. So I'll just quickly show it here. So basically, you have to select any option. Here you have to select FX. In FX, ATM is the keyword. And if you want to go two steps out of the money for 100 points, that will be two steps for Nifty. So just select two here and add Nifty here. And this will be two steps out of the money call. Similarly, if you want to select two steps out of the money put, it will be minus two. Pratik is asking how to buy above 2 days high. So you have to use position keyword. Position will be minus two, candle type will be day. And then you can select the high previous to previous day's high. How to set to trade only from Monday to Thursday on weekly expiry, avoiding Friday. So if you want to avoid any particular day for trading, so you can add one condition. So we have a keyword called weekday. So this returns one for Monday, two for Tuesday, and so on. So if you don't want to trade on Friday, so you can just write weekday not equal to number five. And this condition will not place any trade on Fridays. Okay, so how to set to trade only from, okay, so this I think I have already answered. If ATM straddle is running in no time criteria, just on spot sell. Sorry, I didn't get this question. I want to trade only 100 strikes, but not in 50s. Is it possible? Yes, in strikes, we have a round function. So when you try to add any position, So yeah, in Nifty actually 50 strikes multiple to 50 are not very liquid. So if you want to select a strike which is multiple to 100, so in strike you can use this round keyword. Let's say LTP of Nifty and base 100. So whatever base you put, based on that, it will round to the nearest that multiple. So if I write 50, it will find nearest 50 multiple of Nifty's LTP. So if you want to select nearest 100 multiple to Nifty spot, right? So you just have to add NFO Nifty and base as 100. So this will give you a strike price which is multiple of 100 nearest to LTP of Nifty. Yeah. Can we select premium received for entry in straddle based on bid and ask rate? No, that won't be possible. But based on LTP, yes, you can. And for that, you can use traded instrument keyword again. LTP, in LTP, you have to use traded instrument keyword. Okay, so Ravinder is asking how to do backtest. So once you have created a strategy, please put it on paper trading first. If your strategy is working fine on paper trading, it means there are no problem with the conditions and logic and the formulas that you have put in. Once you are sure that everything is fine and your strategy is taking proper position, then go to my strategies page. In front of your strategy, you'll see an option to backtest. Click on backtest, select the date range. Currently, we have data from January 1st, 2020 till date. So you can select any particular date from which you want to backtest. Select the candle frame and whether you want to trade on open price or close price, you can select that and hit backtest. So backtest will start and you'll get a report or email once it is completed. Sorry, Naveen, I didn't get your question. Where do we find the details of the variables you have created? Variables as in? Are you asking about the keywords that we were using? Okay. So this is the link I'm sharing. This has list of all the keywords that are there on Patreon with the number of parameters that they take and the description of their output type. So you can have a look at all the keywords from here. Okay, any other questions? Maybe I might have missed some of the questions. So if I have not answered any of your questions, please post it again. So we'll check. Okay, so how to select 2 week high. So to select 2 week high, so I'll just go to positions. I'll select high here, minus two. And again, the details about the instrument of which I want to find high, and I can select week here. So this will give me previous to previous week high. And if you want to select what was the high value of previous, which one had the highest high value out of 2 weeks, then you can use position. So highest high value. And in highest high value, you can select for how many weeks you want to check that. So for last 2 weeks, let's say you want to see that. And this will be week. Okay, what is the difference between open positions and position details keyword? So open position just gave you total number of instruments, count of instruments which has position or net quantity not equal to zero. So if you have three option legs open and one got closed, so now you net have two open positions. So open positions will return you value two, which you can use again in any of your conditions. Shitiz is asking, so any of the strategy we choose trade automatically without our intervention? Yes. While deploying strategy, you have an option to select whether you want the one-click automation or completely automated execution. You can select live auto as execution type, and it will work without any intervention. Can we make a strategy based on OI in options and IV? So yeah, IV data we have, but OI data is not there as of now. So if we add that, we'll definitely inform all our users through email. So Kiran is asking how to trade based on time. So at any particular time, if you want to enter, so in your entry condition, you can write time is equal to any number. So time keyword basically returns current time value in HHMM format, hours and minutes. So if it's 9:20 a.m. in the morning, so it will be 9:20. If it's 1:30 p.m., then 1330. So like this, you have to mention the time, and based on the value you have given at that particular time, it will initiate the trades. No, currently we don't have PCR data. So yeah, you won't be able to create strategies on PCR as of now. Right. So Mrs. Sudarshan is asking how to select next week or next month contract if you are trading on expiry day. So we'll discuss that. We have not seen FX in expiry yet. So if you select any option in expiry, you can select FX. And there is an option to select current week or current month expiry keyword. Select underline. And zero stands for current week expiry, one for next week or next month, two for next to next. So like that. Similar to how we used in strike selection. So here you can select next week expiry like this. Manish, I have already shown how to backtest the strategy. So maybe on video recording of this, it will be there. Yes, we have MCX data as well. So can I put a stop loss on my portfolio on 2% of overall value created? So yeah, you can do that in universal exit. You can put a stop loss based on a value. So in universal exit, you can write. So PNL keyword basically gives you profit and loss of this complete strategy across all sets. So you can write PNL, you can write a condition like this. If PNL goes above 20,000, then exit the strategy. Or if you want to put a stop loss, then again, you can do it like this. If PNL is below, this number has to be then minus. minus 20,000, then also you want to exit all the positions, and it will square up all the open positions which are there in this strategy as of now. How to apply strategy on multiple index Nifty and Bank Nifty. So there are two ways. You can create one set for Nifty and one set for Bank Nifty, or you can select a list from list builder. So in templates, there are some strategies based on list. So you can select any particular list. So this list already have Nifty and Bank Nifty. So you can write conditions on this list. In instrument, you have to select the list name. So here in instrument, you have to select the exchange name, and you can select the list name here. So the conditions will be applied to all the instruments which are there in your list and will trade accordingly in which stock the condition are met. Drew is asking if we have backtesting for MCX data. So for MCX, we don't have backtesting as of now. We'll soon add it and we'll inform everyone through email. So which is best strategy currently backtested and working? So I'll suggest you to visit our marketplace and see the strategies with more number of subscribers and the statistics which are there. If you want, you can contact strategy creator as well through email and ask them about their strategies and how it works and the risk parameters and everything. Any regulatory requirement that we need to get before? So you have to get your API details from your broker. To automate trades in your account, you have to put in API details of your account and in broker and exchange section, so that orders will be routed to your own account, trading account. That's it. Is there any way to minimize slippages or best practice to avoid slippages? Slippages are part of every algo system, so there is no typical solution to it. You have to consider slippages and create your strategy accordingly. Like, it should be profitable even after certain percentage of slippages. Yeah. How to apply a strangle at a specific time? So again, you have to use a condition, let's say time is equal to 9:30, and positions will have two positions, one for call and one for put, and it will sell those two positions together. Okay, so Suman is asking, how do I read actual traded price when place a market order? So you can use traded instrument for that. So what was the price of any underlying of set one? If you have multiple legs in your strategy, let's say you have sold call and put both, and put is a second number. So you can write two here and it will give you value of put, the price at which it was traded actually. If positions are held overnight during huge gap up next day, how will it handle adjustment conditions? So you can use repair continuous to initiate some trade to protect your portfolio and square it up next day morning using the same time condition. Kiran is saying some time in few reports, IST time zone is not shown. Yeah, that will be updated. Does Fire provide fully, Fires provide fully automated algo trading? And do we have to click one button daily morning before starting? So Fires do provide the fully automated trading through their APIs. And you have to generate one token. And that process, you will see how to generate that token in broker and exchange section here. So if you select Fires or Zerodha, you'll see this configuration page here. Or even you can check that from partners page, how to set up the API and how to log in to generate your token every day. So in the morning, you have to log in once to generate the token, and then your trading will happen automatically for complete day. Okay, so I think we have answered most of the questions. And sorry if I missed any of the questions, you can definitely write to us at support@patreon.tech. We'll be happy to answer your queries and solve your doubts. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Happy weekend. Bye.